Rose from happyandauthentic.com, and you're watching my second video of my minimalist series. Click here if you want to watch the first one to get all caught up, because today's episode is sort of related to that one. Last week, I explained 18 must-have items that I think every minimalist should own. This week, I'm going to tell you the top 10 things that I think you don't really need and you can safely get rid of, especially if you already have the 18 must-haves. Number one is disposable baking paper, cling wrap, and aluminum foil. These things are horrible. They are really bad for the environment. They cost you a whole bunch of money for no reason. And a lot of the times, they're just not good for you. They leach things into your food, so you don't need them. Trust me, you will feel so much better once you get rid of them. Their minimalist alternative, Teflon or silicone, baking paper, and cling wrap. If you haven't watched last week's video, that's where I explain these in a little more detail. You can also find a link to them down below. Number two is single-use gadgets. By this, I mean any electronic item that only serves one purpose. For example, a Kindle is only an e-reader. A GPS only gives you directions. A camera only takes pictures. It will also take videos. The minimalist alternative, of course, is a smartphone. It combines all of the above plus hundreds of other things all into one handy little device that costs less to charge and takes up less space. Let's be real, pretty much everyone already owns a smartphone anyway, so you don't really need all the extra things. Number three, fast fashion. If you don't already know what fast fashion is, basically it's the concept of fashion that only lasts one season. It's clothing that's really cheap to buy because it was really cheap to make, and so its quality is super low. Usually it falls apart within just a couple of washes, and it looks really terrible to wear. It's disposable clothing, and it's really just a ploy to get you to go spend more money. The minimalist alternative would be to spend your money buying quality clothing that's going to last the test of time. So ditch fast fashion and go for quality. Number four. Plastic food containers. Just like the baking paper and the cling wrap, plastic food containers are a triple whammy, and not in a good way. They're bad for the environment, they're bad for your health, and they're bad for your pocket. They're usually made of really cheap plastics that are full of BPAs, and they fall apart after just a few uses. They can break really easily, they stain really easily, and they're not leak-proof. You can't put them in the freezer or the microwave, and you definitely cannot and should not put them in the oven. A minimalist alternative would be glass containers that you can put in the fridge, microwave, and oven that not only will last you longer, will also be easier to clean, store, and eat from. Not to mention, you can take them anywhere you want and flaunt them proudly because they don't look like crap. Number five, plastic shopping bags. Plastic shopping bags are completely pointless these days, and it makes me really sad that some people still use them. Really, it just comes down to being lazy and not wanting to carry your own. It's super easy to find affordable, well-made, compact, and light shopping bags that will last you for years, with the added benefit that they're not going to fill the world with harmful plastics. I mean, most places charge you for plastic bags anyway, so if you buy your own bags, you'll be saving money in the long run. Number six, using different soaps for different uses. In my previous video, I mentioned a soap called Dr. Bronner's. Basically, this is a Castel liquid soap that you can buy in bulk, and you can use it for any number of different uses. I mean, soap is soap. The very idea that you need a different soap for a different use is ridiculous to me. So if you use the same soap for your dishes, your laundry, your hands, your body, your hair, no harm done. Don't worry about it. But it also gives you an excuse to go out and buy a really good dispenser that you can use for however long you want. It looks way more classy than those tacky plastic ones you buy at the store. Number seven, this one is just for the ladies. Sanitary pads and tampons. Now, I know you hate sanitary pads, so don't even deny it. And I'm sure your tampons have felt uncomfortable at least once. So do your vagina a favor and switch to a menstrual cup. These little things may be expensive, or they seem expensive because you have to buy them up front, but in the long run, they save you a heap of money. So you don't really need all those tampons when you can just replace them with one of these. This is what it looks like outside of the baggie. I mean, how much money do you think you've spent on tampons and sanitary pads throughout your life? For me, it was $5 a month for 15 years. That's $900. If I had just bought a $50 menstrual cup to begin with, I would have saved myself $850. And I can think of a fair few things I could have put that money towards. I mean, what do you have to lose? This is softer, it's more comfortable, it's cheaper, it's healthier for you, and it's better for the environment. Not to mention, it will make your periods lighter and less painful. Because it's silicone, it's not bleached plastic. Need I say more? It's a no-brainer, ladies. Make the switch. Number 8, disposable razors. This is another ploy to get you to let go of all your money. And all these things just go straight to landfill once you're done with them. Razors used to cost me $20 a month, and I'd been using them for 15 years before I made the switch to an epilator. Yes, this epilator and the kit it came with did cost $200, but that's $3,600 that I could have saved if I'd just bought this to begin with. I mean, it sounds obvious when you hear it put in that way, but I didn't realize that I would be buying over 180 razors by my mid-20s. Number 9, disposable water bottles. Now this is another laughable idea, a silly, pointless ploy to take your money, when the simple alternative would be to buy a $5 water bottle like this one and just fill it up with your own water from the tap. I mean, if you're watching YouTube right now, you probably do have access to clean, potable water. So yeah, you just fill up your water bottle and that's it. I know the idea of carrying around a water bottle sounds like it's really hard and annoying, but think of the things you already carry around that you don't seem to be so bothered by. You carry around your phone, your wallet, some of you carry around chargers, jackets, spare shoes and socks. Like, I know people who carry around the weirdest things and they think a water bottle is too much. Adding a bottle of water to the things you already carry not only ensures you're always hydrated whenever you need it, but it also saves you from having to fork out the moolah every time you get thirsty. Which, I mean, if you're like most people, you're probably going to drink at least 2 bottles of water a day, which adds up to 730 bottles a year that are not biodegradable and not always fully recycled. Compare that to the one bottle that you'll be carrying. It costs you $5 to $20, and that's it. You carry it around for years. Plus, you can get one that has a cute little pattern that you're happy with, and a lot of them also have some really nifty features, like collapsible straws, carabiners to hook them up to things, or even UV filters. I'm sure you'll find at least one that you find appealing. Personally, I like the platypus one that I showed you earlier because it's really easy and compact to put away when you're not using it. And when you are using it, you can fill it up as much or as little as you want, and then you can, you know, squish it into places depending on how much room you have left in your bag. Not to mention, you're not going to find a lighter water bottle than this one. Basically just weighs as much as the water you put in it. The last item on this list is paper towels, napkins, tissues, and toilet paper. Basically, disposable paper. If by now you haven't realized that my theme is that disposable things are the devil, I'm probably going to have to do a better job of conveying my point. Now, I'm sure out of all those things, the only thing that you're thinking about right now is the toilet paper, because how dare I suggest that you use anything other than toilet paper to wipe your tush. I understand that imagining a reusable alternative to that may seem gross to you, but trust me, that is an idea that will quickly fade away once you've actually experienced a reusable alternative. In this house, we use a bidet, which basically squirts water where it needs to go to keep things clean. So it's like you've had a little mini shower after every time you go to the bathroom. And then we also have some reusable wipes that are made out of cotton, and we dry off and then put them in a little bin and we can wash those later. Anytime I'm not in my house and I have to use toilet paper, it seems less clean to me. I mean, if you got poop on your hand for whatever reason, would you think it's cleaner to just wipe it away with some paper, or would you wash your hands? Why should our bottoms be any different? Personally, I think it's cleaner to use water and then to wipe it away with an actual wipe. Not something that's like scented and chemical and gross, but something soft and plush and comfortable. Anyway, aside from that, a reusable option for tissues would be, where is it? something like this, a hanky. And I would recommend the brand My Hanky because it's the softest one I've found so far. It's really amazing on your nose and it doesn't cause the irritation that normal bleached tissues do. An alternative for paper towels could be a microfiber cloth, and that's the sort of thing that we use in our kitchen, which you can also use instead of a sponge, you know, to wash your dishes with. So there you go. I just had to end it with a bang talking about poop. But as gross and controversial as some of these may feel when you first start off, or even when you just hear about it, trust me, it not only will be better for you, but it will feel better for you. So at least give them a try before you completely reject the idea. If you listen to all of the tips in this video, you will declutter so much and you will feel lighter, happier, and healthier as a result. If you end up not liking it for whatever reason, at least you've tried it and you can always go back to the way you did it before. So what do you have to lose? Give it a go. Let me know in the comments if I left anything out that you think is important. Like this video if you think it provided valuable information. And if you know anyone who needs help getting rid of any of these things, share this video on your social media. If you're new here, subscribe. I make a new video every Sunday. Join me next week to learn about my top 10 money-saving hacks. See you when I see you.